To solve a rational equation like we have here, our goal is to clear the fractions from the equation and then solve the resulting equation. To do this, we want to multiply both sides of the equation by what would be the least common denominator. So the first step is to write each fraction and make sure the denominator is in factored form. So for this first fraction, we'll write this as x divided by the quantity. Well, 6x minus 36 will factor. These two terms share a common factor of 6. So we can write this as 6 times the quantity x minus 6. And then for minus 9, I'm going to write minus 9 over 1. So everything is in fraction form. And then for the right side, the quantity x minus 6 doesn't factor. So we'll leave it as 1 divided by the quantity x minus 6. The next step is to identify what would be the least common denominator. Well, the least common denominator would have to contain a factor of 6 and a factor of x minus 6. So now we're not going to convert to a common denominator. We're actually going to multiply each fraction by 6 times the quantity x minus 6. So here we'll have times 6 times the quantity x minus 6 all over 1. The same here, and the same here. But there's one more important thing we need to do before we simplify and then find these products. We need to list our excluded values, or the values that x can never be because we'd have division by 0. Notice if we had a 6 here in the denominator, we would have a denominator of 0 here as well as here. So we must exclude 6 as a possible solution. So we'll go ahead and say x cannot equal positive 6. Now that we've listed the excluded values, we'll go ahead and simplify and then find each of these products. Looking at this first product, notice how we have a 6 over 6, that simplifies to 1. We also have a factor of x minus 6 over a factor of x minus 6. Notice our denominator is now equal to 1, and our numerator is just x. So now we just have x minus, nothing simplifies on this product, but that's okay because our denominator is already 1. So we have 9 times 6 times the quantity x minus 6 equals, and then on the right side, we have a factor of x minus 6 over a factor of x minus 6. That simplifies to 1. Again, notice our denominator is equal to 1. The right side of the equation is just 1 times 6, or 6. Now we're going to go ahead and solve this equation. So we have x minus, this would be 54 times the quantity x minus 6 equals 6. Let's go ahead and clear the parentheses so we can think of distributing a negative 54 here. So we have x, negative 54 times x, that's going to be minus 54x. Negative 54 times negative 6 is going to be positive 324, so we have plus 324 equals 6. We'll go ahead and combine the like terms here. We have 1x minus 54x, that's negative 53x, plus 324 equals 6. We're falling down to a basic two-step equation. So now we'll go ahead and subtract 324 from both sides. This is 0. We have negative 53x equals, this is going to be negative 318. And now we'll divide both sides by negative 53. So this simplifies to x. And then negative 318 divided by negative 53 is equal to positive 6. So now it may appear that our solution will be x equals 6, but remember, positive 6 is our excluded value. Therefore, this cannot be a solution. Therefore, this equation has no solution. This is why it's so important that when solving a rational equation, that we take the time to list the excluded values and then check them against the solutions that we find algebraically. I realize that it's a bit of a letdown to perform all this work and then have no solution, but sometimes this is the outcome. I hope you found this example helpful.